What is going on, internet? Jossie Joss here, and I have another box to unbox for you today. It's an unboxing and tasting video today. I got the, what month are we in? February? Yeah, February 2017 Universal Yums. So I'm excited because from what I remember, it's gonna be Italy. And I love Italian food next to obviously like Filipino food and Japanese food. Italian's probably one of my favorite genres of food or types of food. So, I know I won't have like pasta and lasagna in here. That'd be kind of funny. Or a pizza. Oh, jeez, they took extra tape on the box today. But I am excited to see what they have. Italy is actually one of those countries that I really would love to visit eventually in the future. So this is kind of like my first step towards that. I get to visit via snack form. And finally, I got all the tape off. Open it up. Ooh. And look at that. Look at that. It's all fancy now. Welcome to Italy. Remember the days where it used to be just tissues? Looks like they got some money. So it says flip it over for some games. So they have a snack scoreboard now that they're attaching in here, and then they have a little game talking about the cities and the regions, and there's like a little jumble thingy where you have to find out what words are there and then pick certain letters from those words, and then that'll answer a question on the bottom. So we'll get there. But now this is how it looks like when you take the card out. It says Italy. Italy. Ooh, I'm already seeing some chips and I'm like, ooh, those sound yummy. Alright, so as always for the Universal Yums box, there's trivia. So let us see how I do. Trivia answers are always in the back. Alright. Number one, which of the following US cities is named after a Roman dictator? A, Seattle, Washington. B, Cincinnati, Ohio. C, Orlando, Florida. D, Phoenix, Arizona. Seattle? Oh, nope. Cincinnati. Cincinnati, Ohio is named for Cincinnatus, who lived in 500 BC. He was a farmer who wanted the rights of the poor to be protected. He left his farm, defeated his opponents to gain leadership over the Roman state, and then immediately resigned since his goal was met. He only ruled as dictator for 16 days and for centuries has been the poster child for modesty. Oh, that's really cool. He literally worked just to get what he wanted and then he quit. Interesting. All right. Next. Number two. How much money gets thrown into the Trevi Fountain in Rome every day? A, 500. B, 3,000. C, 10,000. D, 30,000. So if you know the song, Three Coins in the Fountain, the fountain that they're talking about is the Trevi Fountain. I'm gonna go big or go home. $30,000. That's a lot of money. A lot of tourists. Over 3,000, okay. So it wasn't as much, but still that's a lot. It says over $3,000 is thrown into the Trevi Fountain every day. That's over $1 million per year. The money is collected by city workers every morning and donated to Caritas, a Roman Catholic charity that provides food for the needy in over 100 countries. That's really awesome. So if you go to Rome and you throw money into the Trevi Fountain, not only will your wish come true or whatever I forgot the whole, thing with the fountain was, but you're also doing a good favor for the Roman Catholic Church over there. So thumbs up. And last question. When McDonald's first opened in Italy in 1986, what did some Italians do in protest? A, give away free spaghetti outside the restaurant to remind patrons of Italy's culinary heritage. B, buy Big Macs just to dramatically throw them away in front of TV cameras. C, sneakily fill ketchup dispensers with marinara sauce. D, form a human blockade so that no would-be patrons could enter. I think B would be pretty funny, but the thing is it'd still be helping the company. But let's do B, buy Big Macs. Oh, nope. A group of Italians cooked spaghetti to a perfect al dente, then served it to would-be patrons. Many Romans were outraged by the restaurant in 1986, calling it a degradation of Rome and Americanization of Italian culture. For this reason, Starbucks hasn't opened a single shop in Italy yet, though plans are in place to launch their first store in Milan this year. That's really interesting. I mean, I don't want to be touchy with, like, Italian food. I mean, like, I'm not Italian, but I understand that whole, like, cultural, like, maintaining the cultural and stuff like that. But dang, it's intense. Oh, well. Anyway, let's see what's in the box. Yay! Exciting. There's some chips here. There's lots of chips and some sweet things. And I'm just excited because it's Italian. All right, so first off, we have these Amica lemon chips. Lemon chips. It says, when life gives you lemons, just ask what the Italians do. lemons are flavored fruit in Italy's culinary scene. They make a lot more lemonade with them. Lemons are stuff, blah, blah, blah. But it says, one thing you'd never expect to pair with super sour fruit, potato chips. Somehow, Italians have made the lip-puckering citrus flavor work well into these thin, salty potato chips. It's kind of like the salt and vinegar-esque type chip, I'm assuming, where that the tang and the acidity kind of just matches well with the potato. So, we'll see. Amaretti cookies. Oh, I've heard of these. I've never had them, like, officially. I always see these on, like, Giada's, like shows and stuff on the Food Network. But these are Amaretti di Sarono Lazzaroni cookies. These are, like, the Amaretti cookies. Let's see, blah, 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 story, blah, 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 okay. So it's basically egg white sugar, apricot kernels, and it's a secret recipe, and yeah, it's just, these are old school, since what, 1718? 1718, this recipe, so I'm excited for this. Alright, next. We'll keep that in there. Anise candy. Do they have a bag of candy like they always do? Yes, they do. Gotta love Universal Yums. I'm probably not gonna have this because anise is a very strong flavor. Like black licorice, that's anise flavored. So these are anise candy. So when you're eating this candy, you're eating the same thing that the Romans used to eat all the way back in 23 AD. But it has anise spice, which has been used for centuries and centuries. It was originally used to alleviate headaches and to aid digestion and even reduce flatulence. So in case you need to, like, you know, let some go, you'll probably eat one, but I'm probably not going to try it today. So this is the next one. Amica, again. Cheese and pepper balls. So they're mozzarella, parmesan reggiano, asiago, provolone, ricotta. Oh my gosh, it's a cheese. Yummy. Sorry, I'm trying to read the thing. It's cheese and ball. It's cheese and, wait, what? Okay, hold on. Sorry. It's talking about different cheeses, and all of a sudden, let's see. It says, we guess it's not surprising that the country with the best cheese balls we've ever tried has a serious love affair with cheese, mozzarella, parmigiano reggiano, asiago, provolone, ricotta. You've heard of many Italy's most famous cheese, but there are also several hundred you've never heard of. Case in point, a cheese called Casamarzu, which is funny because I've actually heard of Casamarzu because I'm a food nerd and that's what I do. This cheese is famous for containing maggots. Maggots eat the cheese, and as it passes through their system, the acid in their digestive tracts just turns it very soft, and when cheese is filled with thousands of maggots, it's ready to eat. That's disgusting, but it is true because I've seen the videos and it's just weird. typically, Casamarzu is served on flatbread, specially made in Sardinia alongside a strong red wine. Okay. So these are just cheese and pepper balls, but they talk about the Casamarzu cheese. The Casamarzu cheese is not, I repeat, not in these cheese and pepper balls. If you are not squeamish, I would suggest going on YouTube and looking up Casamarzu. It's just if you're just interested in just how food is made or food science or where stuff comes from in general, and you're not squeamish, look it up. It's an interesting thing because I mean, it's just a different way of fermentation, but yeah, it's maggots, so but that's a thing. Moving on. Chocolate. These ones. Something in Italian. Monardo Gianduiello chocolates. So these were a special type of chocolate originally produced in northern Italy in a town called Turin. Those Christians and Catholics should know that name because the Shroud of Turin. That is where that name comes from. And there's an old Shroud of Turin, is that's what the cloth that supposedly covered Jesus when he passed or when he died. So anyway, moving on. So this it looks like there's hazelnut in here too, which is funny because like if you know like Spanish or something, Gianduja, I think that's the name. It basically means like hazelnut, so that makes sense that this would be the Gianduja name would be for the hazelnut chocolate. So there you go. Next is something. Where are you? Is this it? Yes. I have to find the label. I have to match the label with the item. So this is a cantuccini biscotti. So we call it biscotti in America, but Italians call it cantuccini. It's a cookie, and it's a convenient snack for soldiers when food was scarce. And apparently even Christopher Columbus brought biscotti with him on his journeys to America. So it's twice baked bread, and it's typically served with wine, coffee, or tea. I've had biscotti before. It's very, very good. So, delicious. Next is to something. Tetere de Puglia Caffirali. Coffee cookies? Something like that? Let's see. It says, with this decadent treat, you'll get two famous Italian exports in one. First is Italian coffee, and then next is a cookie called Tirali or something. There's like a whole little, the paragraph talks about like how to order espresso properly in like a cafe and what you shouldn't be drinking, how you should be drinking, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, because they're very, very, very adamant about their espresso in Italy. I totally understand that. I get it. But I guess this is kind of a combo. It's like a coffee espresso type cookie thing that they have, so. That's really awesome. And I like coffee, and I like cookies, so it works. Next is the Grand Art Rosemary Stuccicina Toscana. They look like crackers. It says, linguine, spaghetti, penne, ziti, fettuccine. Italy could write the book on different pasta types, and those are just 5 out of 500 types. And another book that they could author a book on cracker types. And so they picked this cracker. It's a buttery pillow-like cracker baked with rosemary. I'm not a ginormous fan of rosemary, especially when they overuse it. So hopefully these won't taste too flowery, or it won't be too floral, but we'll see. Next is these. Cabrioni wafers alla nocciola. Nocciola. He wanted, so Pietro Ferrero, as in Ferrero Rocher, wanted to produce a chocolate spread, but cocoa was so rare and expensive that he supplemented it with hazelnuts, which were much cheaper. And it became increasingly popular after the spread was made that we know as Nutella. It became a huge hit. Now Ferrero buys over 25% of all hazelnuts produced. And so these wafers are filled with the creamy filling of hazelnuts and chocolate, and there's sandwich in between wafers. So this sounds amazing, and crunchy and chocolatey and all that good stuff, so. Yay! Tiramisu. I don't know if I can open this yet. I don't know if I want to open it because I want to enjoy this, because tiramisu is one of my favorite desserts. But Zagis il tiramisu. Creamy mascarpone cheese, delicate ladyfinger cookies, fragrant espresso, rich cocoa powder. That's pretty straightforward. And the beauty of this one, it comes with its own spoon. You can see it, kind of. Like, I can bring this to work and be like, I'm on my break. What do you have, Cheetos? I have tiramisu. Because I'm fancy. I don't know. Fancy. Whatever. Amy, moving on. Orange Frolletti cookies. So these are buttery cookies with orange flavor. So pretty straightforward. It's a family-owned bakery or company that started in 1972 in the south of Italy. I love that they're using all these really cool like companies that have been in Italy for years. So it's really cool because they're introducing these like family-owned, you know, classic Italian brands to the people. Especially the ones that can't afford to go to the country yet, you know. I'm working on it. I think this is the last one. The last item. Yep. Monardo chocolate pralines, and that's the little shiny ones. You can see they kind of remind you of, like, Lindt chocolate or stuff like, something like that. Let's see. And these are chocolate pralines, and so we've received a mix of chocolates. So I received, because it's, what did I receive? So, actually, let's see, the blue one, dark blue is milk, and then I think red, is it red? Red and silver is hazelnut cream, okay, got that one, and then about red and gold is hazelnut and cereal, I think that's the only ones that I got. Which is fine. I don't mind hazelnut and stuff. So, I don't know if I'm gonna eat all of that because there's a lot of hazelnut and chocolate stuff. And as hazelnut and chocolate is just amazing. So it's kind of lame for you to like watch me eat things and stuff. So yeah. So they talk about. That's it. Sorry. That's all the snacks that they have in the box for this month for Universal Yums. But in the packet, they talk about romantic areas and things that happen in Italy. So they talk about Verona, Italy, which is the city that Romeo and Juliet is held in. They talk about being single on Valentine's Day, like these little legends and stuff. So that's really cool. And then they talk about the difference between terms in Italy and the United States. So the difference between spaghetti and meatballs, the difference between pizza, and the difference between fettuccine Alfredo. So that's pretty cool because, yeah, it's a very different over here compared to over there. And then they have all these cool attractions that you should go visit in Italy. So I love that they're encouraging people to travel because it's amazing. It's an amazing thing to do. And then, of course, they have the little listing for the music. So, and then the clue for next month is in the back. So we're going to move on to the tasting of the snacks. So I'm going to raise my sleeves. All right. So what am I going to try? What am I not going to try? Sorry. What am I not going to try? I'm not going to do the tiramisu. I could do one of you. I could do you. You. Trying to pull out everything that I can try. Those, this. Am I gonna do a wafer? I don't wanna waste it. These aren't individually wrapped, so I'm trying to avoid that. But I can probably eat one of the candy things. The gold Giambuja things. I think that would be good. And the milk. So like these two things. Alright. So yeah. About 8 things that I'm going to try today from the Italy. Oh! Almost forgot. The biscotti cookie. So 9. 9 things. So. Since I'm here, I'm holding it already, you might as well just get it out of the way. These are the biscotti cookies, the ones that I keep telling about. These are amaretti cookies that I keep talking about that I always see on, like, Giada De Laurentiis' like, cooking shows. So she always uses, like, amaretti cookie. And just really uses her Italian accent. I'm like, yes, lady, we know you're Italian, so... So they're wrapped in this really pretty paper. They smell really good, too. Are there two in here? Oh, there are two. So one little wrapper has two cookies, and they look like this. They smell really good. Mmm. It's good. Amaretto flavor is very strong, obviously. It's got almost like a chewiness to it, similar to like a caramel, but it's still crispy. But yeah, I didn't realize how strong the amaretto flavor is in the cookie, but when they're called amaretti cookies, it makes sense. But they're delicious. Although, the chewiness is starting to get to me. At first bite, they were really, really good. But then as I continued eating it, that amaretto flavor kind of really overtook my mouth and kind of overwhelmed it a little bit. So a little strong. I can see why you could add it into things like baked goods and, you know, all those recipes that she added, like amaretto cookies where she grinded it up and added stuff. I can see why she added it as an accent, but on its own, you need to drink something with it. Glass of milk or something, because that flavor is very strong. Okay. Woo! Good stuff. Moving on. Since I was talking about biscotti, let's move on to biscotti. Biscotti is twice cooked bread. I remember when I went to culinary school, we had to follow a recipe. And so, it's very similar, smells like that orangey flavor. It's got some almond in it, but I remember making a biscotti there. Basically, you make a loaf with the dough, and then you bake it once, and then you let it cool. Then after it's baked, you slice it into the thin slices, which is why you get these little, that's why it's like this, because literally like this oblong loaf on a sheet pan, and you cut them into little wedges like this, and then these wedges you separate onto another sheet pan, and then you bake it again, and that's how you get the twice baked effect. And then these become really, really crispy, and that's why they're ideal for, you know, coffee, tea, and then according to the book, you can drink them with wine too. So biscotti. Very nice. Get that orange coming through. But it's not too sweet. Yeah, the almonds coming in there. Very nutty. Buttery. These are really buttery. But if I had like a cup of espresso or a latte right now, this would be so good. Just like dip it and then boom in my mouth. This is really good. That's like the one thing I'm not a fan of for a biscotti, is the fact that it could probably break a tooth. Aside from that though, super delicious. Honestly, I like the flavor of the biscotti better than the amaretti cookie. I think amaretto, that flavor profile, you can only take it in small like batches rather than like a whereas like the subtleness of like orange zest and almonds is a little bit, you know, I guess in my mind, more palatable. That's me though. All right, let's take a break from the sweet. Actually, we only have 3 savory things, huh? All right, let's just move on. Chocolate. Let's do it. Gian du her de hu de ba ba de ba de ba. This is a chocolate hazelnut thing, I think. It almost, I mean, the wrapper almost reminds me of like a Toblerone. Another yummy old school chocolate. They tell you the story of how my dad found a free Toblerone. We went to the Segerstrom in Costa Mesa once. We were gonna go watch a show, and we were about to go get seated when my dad just happened to see something on the floor on our way out, and it was a Toblerone box. I picked it up. My dad told me, hey, pick it up. And I looked around, there was nobody around. Like, not even the guy selling the stuff was, like, at the counter. Like, maybe he had walked to the back. So my dad was like, just take it. Okay. We ended up with a free Toblerone. My dad enjoyed that Toblerone when we watched the show, by the way. Okay, anyway. Moving on. Chocolate. This is the chocolate that was in that gold wrapper. Oh my goodness. It is so good. If you are a fan of Nutella, if you are a fan of Ferrero Rocher, if you are a fan of chocolate and hazelnut, period, you will love that. That is, it is so creamy. It's so smooth. It is so good. Wow. Bravo, Italy. I shouldn't have had any doubts that their chocolate and hazelnut little candies would be amazing. Duh. I should have known. All right, we have 3 savory things and 3 sweet things left. I'm gonna end with the savory. I'm probably gonna end with the lemon chip, because that just sounds weird to me. And I'll save it for last. It's kind of one of those, like, I don't want to kill my palate with that. So let's do... You. And then you. And then chocolate. And then cheese. And then coffee. And then lemon. Or should I do chocolate and then lemon? You know what, let's keep the sweets, the citrusy things together. There. So next thing I'm gonna try is this coffee cookie. Alright? Then I'm gonna do the rosemary chip. Then I'm gonna do that chocolate thing that looks like a lint that has milk in it, I guess. And then the cheese and pepper. Then the orange cookie. And then the lemon chip. Alright, so. Coffee cookie. I mean, hypothetically, this should be amazing, right? Oh, come on. Come on. Oh, jeez. You childproof this? Come on, there we go. You know it's sealed well. Whoa, that smell. Very intense. Espresso. Ooh. They almost look like cereal. And everything in the back is in Italian. Oh wait, no. Just kidding. There's some English in there. Mm. I don't know what to think of these. Like, not sweet. First off. But, that initial flavor throws me off because it's bitter. Because typical espresso, typical coffee, you don't add the cream, the sugar, and all that stuff. It's bitter. But as you chew, the flavor kind of mellows out. And just kind of settles. I could see why if you ate this with coffee, it would probably be really good. But what's interesting is that one of the ingredients in here is white wine. Italy cooking with wine, sure, why not? Because the first ingredient is wheat flour, so I noticed that right away. It tastes healthy, I guess you can say. And then there's sugar, palm oil, and then white wine, and then coffee, and then olive oil, and then baking powder, and that's it. But white wine. So yeah, I smelled it, and it was really strong, but now that I'm used to it, the flavor is actually okay. That is odd, though. That is very odd. Good, but odd. If you didn't tell anyone about that, they probably would spit it out initially. That was honestly my first reaction. But I decided to not do that. It reminds me of a coffee crouton. Does that make sense? There's coffee in it, but there's like olive oil and flour. Oh. All right. Next. These rosemary chips. Or rosemary crackers, excuse me. Oh, look, they're puffy. Look at that. A pillow. You know what it reminds me of? Macaroni grill. Which is kind of blasphemy. Compared to, like, actual Italian food. I mean, it's good food. But would I call it authentic Italian? Probably not. They have their bread that they serve. It's like a pillow. And it's rosemary. This tastes like that bread. Honestly, I think it's because of the rosemary. Like, this tastes like that bread that my dad loved. My dad loves that bread too. Like, we'll go and he'll want just the bread. And he'll dip it, you know, they give you the little, like, olive oil with, like, a little cracked pepper. Sometimes they'll offer balsamic vinegar if you want. No. This tastes like the cracker version of it. I think I might save these and give them to him. He might really enjoy these. Because we really haven't gone to Macaroni Grill in a really long time. Because my mom doesn't like going there. And there's only so often you can have pasta. Like, can't have it every day. It's too much, so. I'll get my dad those crackers, though. I think he'll be happy about those. Alright. I thought the flavor with the rosemary would be too strong, but it's okay. Moving on, next we have these Monardo chocolate things. This is the latte, which basically means it's milk. It looks like exactly like the Lindt chocolate. So, pretty straightforward. It's just like a milky cream inside of chocolate. Pretty straightforward. Can't screw it up. Well, you can, but They didn't. Honestly, I like the chocolate hazelnut one that I had earlier better. I think because the milk cream, I think it's too sweet compared to the hazelnut, which isn't as sweet, just adds like this other dimension into the chocolate. So it was still good. I'm not saying it's bad. All right, a few more items. Cheese and pepper balls. I'm excited about these ones. I'm a big fan of cheese. My brother likes cheese. My niece likes cheese. I like cheese. And they smell. Ugh. So, some of you guys don't like that Parmesan cheese smell. I actually love it. Because you know it's good. They look like this. Pretty straightforward. Oh, damn. One minute. I need some private time. No, I'm just joking. Amazing. So good. I didn't know that the pepper really like popped so well with this. It cuts in with this really, really good, like it cuts through the cheese flavor so well. This is like cheese puffs upgraded. Like, this is like a Cheeto wearing like a bow tie to a fancy restaurant that they made reservations for like a year in advance. Like, that's what these taste like. I am probably going to continue eating those after the video is filmed. Oh, wow. So good. Woo. I'm almost kind of sad because the other two are not those and I can't continue eating the cheese puffs. But I have to continue for the sake of science and snacking. All right. Next. Frolletti Arancia orange cookies. I'm feeling these are going to be very similar to the biscotti. Because the biscotti had that orange flavor to it. We'll see. It smells the same. But they look like this. So maybe they're like baby biscotti? Ish. It's very mild, the orange flavor in here. I prefer the texture of these cookies compared to the biscotti, but I like the flavor of the biscotti more than the flavor of these cookies. Because I think the orange in the biscotti is more natural or just more prevalent. These just taste like shortbread cookies that has like hints of orange. They're not bad, but we call them orange cookies. I really want to taste that orange in there. And the biscotti had more orange flavor than these cookies. All right. Last item of the day, the lemon potato chip, the weirdest one of the group, by the same company that made the cheese puffs, so hypothetically they should be delicious, but I don't know. The smell reminds me of a salt and vinegar pet chip, where it's very like strong, like, I mean, they look like pretty much straightforward potato chips. Ooh. That is tart. Yeah. They're good. But they do the that whole that salt and vinegar-esque type like reaction where the tartness and the acidity of the lemon is similar to the vinegar aspect, and then the salt comes in and the potato kind of helps balance everything out. So as you get used to it and you start eating it more, it's not as shocking, but it's delicious. Very good. I personally am a more of a fan of the cheese puff thingy, but these are good too. Good. Overall, Lily's got some tasty treats. I mean, there's a whole reason why I love Italian food. It's because they like flavor. And they like flavor that I enjoy. I'm not a huge spice person, so spicy stuff is not my thing, but I love flavorful things. I love things that just provide yummy flavor, and I'm a big fan of cheese. I'm a big fan of hazelnut and chocolate, and I love orange too. So like all those flavor profiles, this box is amazing. This is probably one of my favorite boxes that I've received from Universal Yum since I've been subscribed to them. So, favorite item, obviously sweet, is that chocolate hazelnut gold bar looking thing. I don't remember the name of it. And then the favorite savory item was obviously the cheese and pepper puffs. These guys that I'm going to be continuing to eat after we're done filming. But yes, but that is the February 2017 Italy box from Universal Yums. If you are interested in getting a box for yourself, I'll go ahead and put information in the description below. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already done so, please subscribe to my channel. I have a whole bunch of other unboxing and tasting videos on there from previous months. You can see all of them. But until then, thank you for your support. Thank you for staying tuned and watching this entire video. I know it's really long, so I appreciate it. But until next time, have a great night, guys.